outcry is the motto for this crew, sure, but also for this rebooted movie franchise.
I thought we'd be robbing banks by now. Not some gas truck in the middle of nowhere.
Isn't this something you say before you go to rob the gas truck in the middle of nowhere? Movie expects me to believe this go into reverse via e-brake turn maneuver is possible at 60 miles an hour. This pickup truck can travel in reverse at the same speed as a semi-truck on the highway. Because, well, this is only the beginning of this crap and you know it. Well, that's some bullshit. Why doesn't everyone have the same hands-free headset that Letty does? It's really strange to me that during these heists, absolutely no one else drives on these roads. The one thing they never counted on was the truck driver seeing something odd in his mirrors. This bullet hits exactly in the spot where Toretto's torso is, and all he has to worry about is shattered glass? Oh no, something! This guy pumps the brakes once, then bails at a lot of miles per hour, and lives! How has this gas tank on fire not exploded yet? Sometimes an exciting scene is so much bullshit the danger isn't real anymore. After this, there's no reason to feel any tension. Spectacular explosion just for the hell of it. All the excitement of the first movie, without the thes. Movie is a dick to epileptics, but is kind of a good friend to my boner, so I'm conflicted. None of the girls in any of these shots is my girlfriend. So they stole a gas truck to use for illegal street races? Is gas that hard to come by? Don't you f***ers bet pink slips and shit? How is a $40 fill-up that big a deal?
Time for you to go do your own thing.
Heard they're doing some crazy shit in Tokyo.
Like nearly drifting this franchise into obscurity.
Dumb. How long have we been doing this?
I have no idea, but I'm gonna guess long enough to know better.
We'll figure it out. We always do.
Man, that's touching. I really hope these criminals find a happy ending. Dom is a dick to Letty, but at least he left the cash on the nightstand, like she's a whore. Running! Paul Walker! B-plot! How's the movie so far, gentlemen? Jump cut chase scene has no intention of letting you get your bearings. Rando security guard goes out like a bitch, and gives up his gun so the scene can have added tension. Jeez, just call backup, dude. He had no place to go. They both survived this.
Give me a name! David Park!
Amazing I can remember that, after crashing through a f***ing car. Why am I even alive?
David Park? I could throw a fortune cookie out this window and hit 50 David Parks right now.
That's super racist. Also, that's one magic fortune cookie. Wait, how did O'Connor get another job after absolutely f***ing the police rulebook the last movie?
Tom, it's Letty. She's been murdered.
Because you left her alone, most likely. Also, amazing that her death means so little to this franchise, it wasn't even shown on screen. Probably so they can bring her back later. Everyone in the movie decides to believe Letty's dead without seeing a body, which is convenient beyond words.
Facial recognition software matched Toretto about 10 minutes after he crossed the border. Thought he'd show.
Even though I supposedly have cop instincts, there's no reason for me to check other areas of the cemetery where he might be watching the funeral. Also, how is it that you don't have anyone watching the streets in and around the cemetery just in case he shows up anywhere near the area? Out of 360 degrees, Brian chooses to dramatically look in the one spot where Dom had actually been. Cops are staking out this home, but not the back way, which Dom so obviously used to sneak in here.
They're staking the place out if they find you.
They won't.
That's all I have to say about that. Anyway, cops are dumb.
Letty wouldn't let them junk it.
You mean the cops? Letty wouldn't allow law enforcement to junk the car? Isn't it their property after that Brian-Dom drag race at the end of the first movie?
I'm gonna see the crash site.
I'm going to crack this case because in addition to being a badass car heist guy, I'm also an honorary Scotland Yard sleuth.
If we don't make serious inroads into the Braga case in the next 72 hours, they're gonna shut us down. Because it's been 2 years, and the last three agents we sent to infiltrate his organization have come back in body bags.
So basically, the government will be cool with all his illegal activities after that, because this case is too damn hard. Also, you sent three other undercover dudes before sending Brian undercover god O'Connor?
Your boy Toretto's Red Chevelle's been spotted in his old neighborhood. Gonna bring his ass in.
Despite this fact, we'll let him drive all the way here, and then we're going to show up after Dom does his Sherlock Holmes routine, because nobody in law enforcement is worth a shit. Vin Diesel is fast and curious. Oh shit, he can actually create memories of an accident he knows nothing about by merely standing on this road? He is really good at deducing.
You found something back there.
Yes, memories that are not from my own brain.
There were burn marks on the ground, the kind that could only be caused by natural meth. There's only one guy in all of LA that sells that.
This is something the detectives couldn't figure out. This is f***ing police work 101. Also, what a bunch of bullshit. One guy? One f***ing guy sells something that is this coveted in the street racing world? One f***ing guy? Sin City stylized driving shot brought to you by Sin City.
So here I narrowed it down to 50 or so David Parks.
I want you to throw a fortune cookie at them like that racist agent was talking about earlier. See which one flinches. That's your man.
Don't ever put your hands on me again, okay? Say hi to your sister for me.
Jesus, what world does this dude live in?
Korean kid brought it in. David Park.
Brian might be one of the worst agents in history. Letty's murder case didn't lead Brian to the same information Dom just got. The only guy who sells nitromethane in the area, and the one guy who knows what David Park and his car look like.
I lied to you.
Well, no shit.
I lied to Dom, I lied to everybody. That's what I do best, that's why the feds recruited me.
Brian's amazing lying was so renowned they recruited him for it. Of course, how did they know he was a liar if he was so good at it? And Brian didn't get in any trouble for letting the girl go yesterday by tricking the other FBI guy and faking transfer orders.
98 Saturn, a 95 Sebring, a 98 Nissan 240 with an illegal mod.
Wait. That's it.
Why didn't you plug in all the David Parks with an illegal mod in the database and narrow the search time down? Jesus, do I have to do everything for you? Fate and the screenwriter have conspired to get Brian and Dom to investigate the same guy at the same exact time.
All I can do is get you in the race.
What race?
The guy who is spilling his guts somehow decides to stop so that this window breakage can happen. Either that or Toretto threw him through the window before giving him time to answer the question. There is no freaking way Park was able to hold onto a curtain after being dangled out of a window by his feet and then dropped.
Connor, do you know the difference between a cop and a criminal?
What?
One bad judgment call.
Whether or not you mean to, you're saying that all cops have avoided making one bad judgment call, which is preposterous.
We have intel that Braga's number two, Ramon Campos, will hold a street race in Koreatown tomorrow night to fill a slot on his team.
Let me guess, winner gets the slot.
Did you just say let me guess and then fill in the rest of the sentence with information the first dude already said? This double-fisted montage of car work makes me f***ing angry. Are they gonna mirror each other the entire film?
You one of Park's guys, Blondie?
I'm wondering, how does a guy who blew his cover in the first movie get to go undercover in this same street racing world a second time with nobody noticing him?
My job is to find the best drivers. Period. Whoever wins the race gets the info.
This seems like a weird way to get your trusted drivers. You run one race, something that could easily end in a fluke, and that's how you pick people? Revving, tires, satellite maps.
You sure you want to do this?
Can he even hear you with all this noise? Is it possible for a car on only two wheels to move faster than cars on four wheels? I'm sure it is, but it probably requires either sluggishness on the part of the other drivers, or those two tires touching the ground moving at a speed twice that of any other car's tires. Which is kooky, right?
How my ass look, Chia Pet!
The 2009 movie makes a Chia Pet reference, yet will spawn at least three more sequels, because there is no god. No cops were called in the running of this massively inconvenient street race. Brian should definitely have killed some fools here, but for the power of screenwriting.
Sorry, car!
And then this car proceeds to bust through a wooden staircase and down a hill without stalling or busting tires.
At least we know you can't beat me straight up!
I didn't know there were any rules.
True that, Dom. It actually makes me wonder why you guys didn't start racing immediately before the countdown got to zero. Wouldn't this kind of race reward cheaters? Stupid guy is getting his stupid face arrested during sexual relations cliche. Wherever this is going on, cops would be noticing. This is some loud, invasive shit right here. This girl's ass is not my girlfriend in this seat. I mean, this girl is not my ass in this seat. I mean, this ass is not- oh, f*** it.
Yeah, Corona.
Dom orders without the waitress even acknowledging him.
Let's just stop someone from telling him you're a cop.
Are we still going with the idea that Dom is the only guy who recognizes Brian? This guy's face was everywhere in that first movie.
I also heard you just got out of county.
When Brian arrested David Park, the race was the very next night. So how did Brian get the just got out of county street cred? Don't undercover guys have to actually be in jail for a while so that it can be verified? They simply go on Park's word, which I cannot believe is how this worked, considering how hard Braga is to find.
Any one of them would die for Braga.
Including you.
Especially me.
Even though Brian is a dumbass and doesn't realize it, Braga basically just gave away his identity. This is the guy who's so hard to find. This is the guy who's killed three other FBI guys before he could be identified.
Braga's mine. I'm taking the whole house now.
And also talking about it in front of a club full of people you were just told are so loyal to Braga they'd die for him. This room with the boss is no longer important to guard now that a girl with a hot ass just walked by. How does Brian know this door isn't leading to a single dead-end room, at which point he'll be caught by the boss man for snooping? Answer, he f***ing doesn't. Thankfully for Brian, everything about the layout of the rest of this building cooperates with his eavesdropping. Same here. Don has no f***ing clue where this elevator will take him, but whatever. Can we just go back to the three girls kissing?
Are you one of those boys who prefers cars to women?
I'm one of those boys that appreciates a fine body regardless of the make.
Are we at a James Bond film all of a sudden?
A dirty shot glass, just what I always wanted.
How in the f*** did Brian get into the office where Braga was drinking without being seen?
So that means I have to contact individual agencies, and that could take weeks.
Fingerprints somehow take weeks of verification. But hey, that's convenient for the plot, so that's something we have going for us.
Yeah.
That's your third traffic violation in less than three blocks.
Is this guy serious? Doesn't he know what Braga expects from his drivers?
He stopped.
Thanks, movie narrator. Bad guy gives potential undercover agents plenty of time to destroy any bugs they might have in their cars by making it way too obvious, and not inspecting all the cars at the exact same time. Also, it makes you wonder how dumb the other FBI guys were to get killed by this guy. Also, luckily Brian has an unfinished can of NOS in which he can throw this bug. That's some seriously convenient product placement right there.
I don't have a tally on the target, repeat. I don't have a tally on the target.
So the FBI knows that Brian went into this one place, but when a huge truck comes driving out of it, they don't follow it for any reason? How do you build a tunnel like this on the Mexico border without anyone ever noticing?
You're running out of time.
Do the drivers, who are driving as fast as they can, need anyone telling them to get out as fast as they can?
70 Plymouth. Her name was Letty.
Dom spills all his cards during Mexican desert standoff with bad guys that have guns.
Somebody wrecked a car.
I wrecked a car.
So you can tell this is a guy bent on revenge. Why don't you just go ahead and kill him right now?
Last time I saw it was burning.
The Dom you have presented in these movies would crush this f***er's neck right here and now. even if he has some NOS cigarette lighter bomb ready to explode soon.
Come on, get in the fucking car!
Somehow I'll be able to guide us back over the Mexican border without my FBI buddies tracking us, not to mention Border Patrol. Wait, Dom is getting in the Humvee with Brian and leaving without killing the guy that killed Letty? What was all that about then? Are there seriously no cameras on an impound lot? And what happens when they drive out of here in a completely different car and there's a smash window on the driver's side? Does the guard say, okay, move along?
Well, it's not in there.
Do you have x-ray vision or something? Corona continues their assault on your good taste with second egregious product placement. I have no idea where they are now, and the sister had to drive to get to this oil field trailer, but somehow there is a box full of Letty memories for Dom to sift through. Magic! I wonder, how much of a discount does Campbell's Soup get for product placement that is blurry as hell but still obvious? Dom knows who killed Letty, but he's unnecessarily curious about who she was talking to before she died, so that he and Brian can fight.
She did it for you, Dom! She did it for you!
Brian waits a stupid amount of time in this fight to share the fight-stopping information. With a single fist brush, Brian removes all the blood caused by 10 punches to the face Dom threw a second ago.
Let's use the shipment to lure Braga out and mop the head off a multi-billion dollar cartel.
And how do you suggest we do that?
A hand-to-hand exchange with Braga.
He'll never show. He can't afford not to.
You just said this was a multi-billion dollar cartel. The shipment you're talking about is 60 million. Sorry to say, Braga isn't going to stick his head out for that. But for the movie, he will.
What do you want?
It's delivered by Braga himself.
Well, that's not a suspicious way of trying to get Braga at the meeting. Nope, not at all.
O'Connor hasn't given us a signal yet.
What part of that didn't you understand? We just got confirmation. Do it!
Because that's how FBI operations are done. You go against the plan midstream because you got a supposed fingerprint match in an extremely fluid situation. This isn't much of a surprise, so I guess we'll send dramatic irony here. Machine guns go off in every possible direction and somehow everyone doesn't die. This inch girl, for some reason, runs out and stops in front of her boss's speeding car. I guess so Dom could save her and she could be in future sequels. Wait, are you telling me that absolutely no FBI guys are around to stop this car just in case this exact thing happens?
It was under your nose the whole time.
You know, he's right. He should have known. But even with intuition, he had to verify fingerprints, which, somehow take weeks to verify even if you're in the FBI.
Toretto's heading south, probably long across the border by now.
Despite the fact that we have facial recognition software that verifies this type of shit, and should know he hasn't crossed the border yet.
The first bad guy you helped escape the law's grasp?
Actually, he is. He's just done it twice for the same person now. Of course, none of the angry-at-Brian FBI agents are staking out Toretto's house, because that would make too much sense.
Everyone's looking for you.
But not here, for some reason. Hey, you're crying. I've got just the thing for that. Also, let's f*** right here in the kitchen, because God knows there's no way your brother Dom will stumble upon such a horrific sight. If it's so easy to cross the Mexican border, why all the drama going through the Batman tunnels and shit to get a shipment? Just admit to me you created that scene through the tunnels so you could have a cool car scene. I'm a big boy, you can tell me. Something about this note passing scene is keeping me from paying attention to the note passing. I can't quite put my finger on it.
So this is where my jurisdiction is?
Being that I'm not an FBI agent anymore, I don't really have jurisdiction anywhere. I don't even know why I said that. Well, they aren't all black, but these are definitely tailgating SUVs. Two of the three telltale signs of an evil convoy. Hey, remember what hot chick I'll never bang said?
Going in there is suicide.
Yeah, it seems like they got in there without it being even remotely suicidal. All of his dudes are out front, and this is a church, so it has other exits.
You and me, we know so different.
You and I are not so different, cliche. Wait a minute, my evil boss's prayer is taking too long. I'd better go insert myself into the plot. Security fail. You didn't even know about the side entrance, let alone have a guy guarding it?
You'll make it a couple of miles out, if you're lucky.
Your cars, which are souped-up Amazotrons, cannot possibly outrun my guy's cars, which are super-duper souped-up Amazotrons. Cockfighting.
You know where you're going?
He should, but somehow he'll not have a proper escape plan.
Where you boys at? How are they gonna show up or what?
Right after you say this, I'm sure. How did the bad guys know to show up to this random spot in the middle of the Mexican desert? At best, they got a message the boss was kidnapped and the kidnappers were headed out of town. But all of them show up at the same time and correctly guess which spot outside of town to go to? How is there a f***ing red station wagon in on this chase? This is a multi-billion dollar cartel, goddammit. Also, how did these dumbass cars catch up to the souped up f*** you cars that Dom and Brian drive? How? Only one evil henchman is smart enough to know this obvious rule.
Dom, head to the tunnel! Let's use the tunnel!
What? You just so happen to be at the exact same stretch of US-Mexican border as earlier in the movie? How convenient. Suddenly, all the Mexicans!
This might hurt!
After one time through these tunnels, he knows he can smash through the entrance like this without killing himself. For all he knew, that entrance was made of steel, but thankfully the correct answer is papier-mâché. Brian waits entirely too long to do this. Brian survives this. Awkwardness acknowledged. The last time we saw Dom, his car got super banged up, and a bunch of cars were wrecking into it and causing various tunnel block issues. Now the car looks essentially brand new and is driving perfectly without any issue. Thank God for film editing, right? That makes people totally forget shit like that. No. Huge rocks are obviously falling in front of Dom, but Dom sees your rocks and raises you, infinity, impossible escape. Instead of shooting Brian, this moron decides to monologue by kicking. Brian somehow grabs dude's leg to hold him in place, but also then isn't smashed by the impact of Dom's car on this guy's body.
I've listened to the testimony and taken into special consideration Agent O'Connor's appeal of clemency on behalf of Mr. Toretto.
How does the judge consider Brian's appeal, since he's no longer an agent and performed an illegal operation in Mexico as a civilian? What was the point of that no longer on active duty scene? Even prisoner transfer buses drive on interstates with nobody on them. Man, if heists and prison breaks were this easy, everyone would do them. Sorry, disclaimer. Everyone who's dumb enough to do the stunts from this movie are already in the lobby talking about how sick this movie is.
Last time I saw it, it was burnt.
Say that the same thing every time. I'm through, never again, too dangerous.
I know, that's what I always say. I'm always right, too.
But you forget about it in a day or two.
Yeah, well, the days of me forgetting are over. The days of me remembering have just begun.
Tommy! How's the peeping?
Tamale!
They ran over here. They were followed.
The belt!
Tracks lead away from the battle.
Into Fangorn Forest.
You know, if I were driving this long, dangerous mission for Braga, I'd bring along some freaking snacks. Any logical person would, really. Which is why none of these idiots did in the movie. You need variety, too. Salty. Sweet. Salty sweet. What I'm saying, really, is that these Fast and Furious guys could really stand to benefit from signing up with NatureBox.
Lay off me, I'm starving!
Heck, if you go to naturebox.com/cinemasins right now, courtesy of a special offer for our fans, you can get a free sampler box of their most popular snacks.
Wow, that sounds like a really good deal.
This isn't some lame-o Jelly of the Month Club.
It's a one-year membership in the Jelly of the Month Club.
This is NatureBox. Hundreds of delicious and healthy snacks delivered to your door every month, free to cancel anytime. But you won't want to, because of the deliciousness. Like PB&J granola, my absolute utmost favorite thing to eat in the world.
Yummy.
So, everybody, let's all...
We're going streaking! Yes!
No, not that. Instead, get thee to naturebox.com/cinemasins and sign up to get your free sampler box today. What you do after that is your own business.
Oh, that's not right.
Let's go, everyone. All of you. Come on, no stragglers. Hey everybody, if you have an interest in a book about disabled superhero kids, I just happened to write something like that. And you can now pre-order the ebook version. The audiobook is coming soon as well.